The overcrowding in the Louisville jail quietly turning to a high-tech solution, an ankle bracelet with built-in GPS. But how well does it work?
WLKY investigative reporter Dwayne Pullman has spent years chasing the law. He put on the new device for a spin for the chase him. How did you do with the new monitoring device? They get you, Dwayne?
Well, it does a very good job. No question, it's a big improvement from the old radio-controlled ankle or wrist bracelets, which are still being used. As you'll see, the high-tech device can and does track every move, but is it enough to protect you and me from criminals?
As the jail continues to bulge with prisoners, Metro Corrections is increasingly turning to this.
We have entered the GPS arena.
A high-tech ankle bracelet loaded with satellite software.
Which means we're going to be tracking them in real time.
To monitor an increasing number of nonviolent prisoners sentenced to home incarceration. While the GPS anklet was put into service just a year ago, 340 prisoners on home detention are already wearing it.
We can track individuals in the community in real time, 24/7, 365.
I agreed to test that.
I'm your inmate.
Becoming a prisoner for a day.
Step one would be we'd measure you.
Corrections officer Kevin Rowan readies the new GPS anklet.
There it is. We're all a go.
A tone signals that I'm now in Metro Corrections tracking system.
The beep means we're activated.
It means you're officially ours.
Officer Rowan enters my information in his computer and adds an exclusion zone. He picks WLKY's address.
So I can't come with 500 feet of the station.
Of the station.
WLKY.
Yes, sir.
I'm not allowed. There are many at the station who would thank you for that.
In real life, that zone protects a victim or witness or anyone the suspect or criminal is not supposed to have contact with. In minutes, I'm out the door and into my car.
I'm leaving the parking space right now.
Well, we'll take it up. We'll watch you.
As I drive down Louisville streets,
do you see me moving on the map?
The map on Officer Rowan's computer is catching my every move, including my route to the station. As I get near the WLKY back entrance,
there we go.
The device goes off, and soon I'm talking to Officer Rowan on the phone.
I need you to leave that area.
So I'd be arrested.
I would tell you to leave, but I'd also be heading that way to arrest you.
In real life, nonviolent prisoners with high risk factors, like repeat offenses, are picked for GPS. While the system is impressive, even Metro Corrections Director admits some criminals can escape its gaze.
Well, of course, it's possible. It's not a panacea. It's not going to prevent somebody from doing something bad.
A laser embedded in the band sends an automatic alert when it's severed. Several GPS units have been cut off, which bring felony charges, including escape.
Is it going to prevent somebody from doing something bad? No.
Prisoners selected to wear the GPS anklet pay $5 a day to wear them. And as the director will tell you, that's a huge turnaround for taxpayers who pay $70 a day for each bed at the jail.
Is this the new jail?
You know, I think that's a really good question. I think that we have to look at all applications of technology that are designed to protect the public, but at the same time, save money.
Now, the new GPS units, as you heard, are not foolproof. As a matter of fact, we did some checking. Several prisoners, we're told, did manage to cut them off. All of the prisoners were returned to jail. The units recovered, we're told, except for two, which ended up in the landfill. I'm Dwayne Pullman, WLKY News.